Alright, it's time for plays the Skylines episode 2. I mean, this is Skylines 2. I don't know what episode this is. 30 something, 40 something maybe. Alright, so. I have two goals. One is to build a bit more residential, and then the other is to do some city beautification. All right, let's take a look at where we're at here. I think I'm turned about, maybe. Yeah, usually I'm looking at it from the other point of view. Like that. All right, so let's see here. Waiting for a hearse over there. I was thinking about maybe doing like an industrial cargo port down here, but I don't know if that's necessary, given that they have the trains going through here. I built a second cargo maybe, but I'm pretty sure I have a cargo port somewhere around here. I don't remember, but let's see. Here's the... Get rid of this. Thought I had one. Highway. Yeah, there's the train. Yeah, I do. I have a cargo terminal up here. I heard that the cargo terminals are not quite operating correctly. There's some kind of a bug with them. Not entirely sure. We've got this geothermal plant here. Very efficient, which is good. All right. So, let's see. There's our harbor, our passenger harbor. Oh, one of the things that City Planner Plays was talking about is how many more people live in apartments versus row homes in terms of being efficient with your population. Right, nobody's living there, they're unhappy. We know there's some noise pollution, but it's low. We don't know why they're unhappy. We just know they're unhappy. And so they left. But it doesn't tell me why it got abandoned, does it? Ah, okay. So there was a lack of entertainment. Is maybe what drove them away? We have a... Where's our nearest park? Let's see. Let's go... There we go. Alright, this whole area is like, nope, nothing to do. Oh, okay, so downtown is in bad shape when it comes to this stuff, even though they've got... Alright, so, I bet it's... I mean, unless it's a bug, I bet it's basically, it's a matter of, population density, I think. But, alright, so let's say, alright, nobody wants to live here. So, let's knock it down and build a park, maybe? Let's do a... Ah! Not what I want to do at all. God darn you. Son of a gun. Yeah. Alright, so let's make this... That. Okay. So that's its thing. Let's go back to parks and this time build a mother flippin' park. Alright, let's see. Large park. City park. Okay. That's a little too big. But maybe a small park there. And a playground there. and a dog park. Oh, you know what? Let's see. Can we get a large one for this abandoned houses are? There we go. All right, cool. And then we will rezone here. We'll do apartment complex if one will go up there. There we go. All right, let's go back to leisure, as the Brits like to say. All right, so there's none for... Is this a parking lot? All right, let's... I guess that'll be our thing. Instead of city beautification, we will work on making sure everyone has some leisure. So these guys that we screwed over, let's therefore say we'll pull a park there. All right, why does not provide... So that's odd. Oh, no. Why doesn't that provide happy park for these folks? That must be some kind of bug or something. All right, let's go over here. Got a parking lot. Got a bunch of... All right, these are just... Okay, there's some houses there. This is commercial again. Commercial. And here, what have we got? Commercial. This is like this big commercial area. So, we probably are fine-ish. These are commercial. I mean, residential. All right. So what happened here? High rent. Okay. Let's see what we can do about this here. All right, I think you're complaining about high rent. There you go. Yep. And then I make this medium density, and maybe can we like pull this up by one? Just one. Nope, it's too far. Oh, so we could put like a little apartment complex right there. All right, in that case, let's go here. Just make a little sidewalk here since it can't be used for the house. Just let people, oopsie daisy, what did that do that for? That's weird. What in the bloody heck just happened there? Weird. Let's pull dozers and see what's going on. Interesting. So zoning that made us lose our housing on the street, which is weird as all get out. All right, that doesn't touch the street, so that's... Shouldn't be zoned then. Oh, weird. Okay. Interesting. All right, anywho. Back to our parks department.
This is Second Moon Radio, classical for the modern age. Unlike most modern music classical has always been penned by someone sitting in front of a sheet of blank paper, using only their imaginations as guides, through a silent audio masterpiece. Now, here we sit, listening at full volume, as our souls are transported. But let us not tarry. On to the next rapisode.
A housing shortage is driving up prices in the area.
That's right, Leather. But apparently that's not all good news. We're joined today by an expert guest, Professor Nutbutter.
Welcome, Professor. So a housing shortage is bad for the people trying to move here, right?
Humans are programmed to desire certain representations within ideological reward structures, which are entirely apart from the actual rewards enjoyed. For example, consider capital.
One final question, Professor. Is the housing shortage...
Let's see if we can... Some more folks here.
Matrix, perhaps, yes, in the short term.
I like the sound of that.
But what we are discussing is the study of a statistical abstraction. And
all right, there we go.
Thank you, Professor.
All right. We've got that going on.
Interesting news from the city's export division. Sources tell us...
Let's go back to our view here.
...services than we know what to do with.
And you know what that means, folks. It means we're not cutting things close enough.
Well, no. The point is we're selling it and bringing money into local...
Fine waste pollution.
It's too much of a good thing.
Or we could say that we're enjoying a positive trade balance and the economy is booming. More after this.
Right, let's get back to leisure, I guess. Let's see. These are businesses. Get some housing here. Oh, what happened here? Abandoned. High noise pollution? Is that why? I don't know. Who knows, man? Can't even tell. Alright, let's see. Unreliable mail service. So mail service is really killing them, huh? Possible this is a bug, I'm not entirely sure. Alright. So these guys need more customers. Alright. So. Mail is kind of key factor all over the city, huh? Okay, well, oh, whoa. Overall, people are relatively happy here. Oh, there are some places being abandoned. Lack of entertainment. Out. Well, might as well take advantage that it's abandoned there. This helps nobody, huh? Well, next game I need to make sure that I'm popping leisure as I go. Why didn't that turn it green? That's weird. Maybe that's not the type of leisure they want or something? I'm not entirely sure. Yeah, at least I'm making money now. Why did these guys leave? Lack of entertainment. Always lack of entertainment. You'll have to figure something out. Okay. What is this? It's a pretty tall building. Small homes, high noise pollution. Well, not exactly easy to. Figure that out. Maybe some other people will move in eventually. Alright. So I think what I want to do is come over here, work on some beautification over here. And the hillside snobs. Alright, so let's see. Here. I want to switch to my road menu. I want to do. Let's see. Here, grass on the side of the road. And trees. Very cool. And that's trees without grass. Oh my gosh. Alright, that eliminates the street parking for them. But it'll look nicer. Oh. All right, yeah, looks pretty good. I mean, the trees will eventually grow. Now they're little baby trees. And you can park over there, I see. Okay. Sure, why not? We'll do trees on the opposite side of the street, I guess. Okay. It wasn't transparent here. It makes it a bit harder to see. There we go. Yeah, we have it planted on one side of the street, not the other. And as we come on over here, yeah, we can keep doing it because there aren't any houses here that we would be preventing parking. I mean, if they have visitors, but otherwise, let's see. All right. Guess I should check these guys for leisure because I didn't really build any parks for them. Oh, they're all okay. Maybe I did build a park for them and I forgot about it. Okay. Alright, so I think let's see. What was here? This was I don't want to buy this just for that, but maybe I extend the land out a little bit, get a little more buildable area. All right, let's see. What's going on? Let's see. Is that like beach or something? Is that what that is there? Alright. Okay. We'll go ahead and build this out. Came out at an angle that way. I need to buy some more land. What is that cluster of stuff over there? Oh, it's gone.
A driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions.
See here.
Please exercise caution if you must drive and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
You're listening to Second Moon, the station for the cultural sophisticate who doesn't fear extending their ears to the more challenging sphere of the classical genre. Let us move now from the musical page to the literary. Here we have some perfectly anguishing correspondence from a listener. My dear Professor Hornbuckle, whereas I make no apology for my erudite,
let's see here.
demands that I prevaricate against the title. I am but a humble devotee of the form, and all my expertise derives merely from a life devoted to the gentle arts.
Right. Though I do attempt to respect the typography.
But I digest. To continue. Professor Hornbuckle, as a traveler from my homeland, I long to hear a tune that speaks to the anguish of my road-weary soul. There now, my good fellow. Chin up, as it were. No need.
Here we go.
Sediment. Leave right. That to those poor chaps.
Let's see here.
Here's a tune just for you, and I do hope it provides your aching spirit some modest
back to
desolation.
Industry right. In the region is on the rise, and when business is doing,
you know what? I think what we're gonna have is a bunch of like little streets that come out. Something kind of like.
And onto our main
curve, maybe.
The commercial district is booming as the area is attracting more high-end stores, bringing the latest in luxury to our neighborhood. You can now shop for designer shoes while sipping a fancy local Java mate, or so my wife tells me. That's good for business and good for the community.
Thanks, Jim.
Right here, we'll come out. Come out from this side, curve like that. It'll just be a little eccentric little neighborhood here. Yes. All right, cool. Let me be right back. All right, so before I forget, let me just do my trees and whatnot. We'll go from here. Trees. Let's do clinic right, you know what, I think right here we'll do crematorium right there, school, do an entry school right there. Let's see. Fire. Do one there. Police. Looks like they're covered on police. They're fine. Alright, let's set some parks. I'm gonna do. Some basketball courts, like right there. Take a skate park here. Some tennis courts right there. Community pool there. I think That should cover most of it. So now, let's see. Electricity, this should be okay. Oh, internet. Let's see. Internet. These guys don't have internet either. Alright, so that takes care of those guys. We'll have some internet here, there, and mail. Taking advantage of all the money I have now and kind of looking at like what City Planner Plays does, where he kind of does a lot of the stuff ahead of time. All right, so that should take care of my amenities. Let's start placing housing. All right, so let's go to the paint bucket. All right, so what I want to start with is, let's see, like right over here, some single family home. Then I think perhaps like right along like this ocean road, there might be like a place to shop here, a place to shop here. I see this as mostly a residential neighborhood, but there'll be a few, you know, along this ocean road here. There'll be some businesses, maybe like right there. Right, and then I think there'll be some row homes on this street here. Okay, and then let's see, we'll have single family homes here. Now, apartments. I think got some apartments along this back road here. Okay. And going back to single family homes, we'll kind of do here. Right. Let's see. Might want to do some parking since we've got these trees along the road, and that eliminates some of the street parking. So we'll put some here by the apartments, right there. Yep. Let's see. We'll put some here by the businesses. This one will be also next to the park. Let's see. So I think I would definitely have some single family homes along back here. Here. You know what? I'll leave those blank. I don't want to invite water here, but this will be single family for sure. Let's see, we could have a row house there. If they want to zone. And then, let's see. This is a parking lot, right? Yeah. You know, I think I have some medium density there, like an apartment complex. Right, we'll have some houses here. Interesting, so they'll have to park across the street because of where the trees ended up. Housing here. There's another parking lot, so we'll do apartments. Okay. And on this side, we'll just do what should go here next to these. I think row homes would look kind of nice there. I can't wait till this area develops and we can kind of like take a little, zoomed in look at it. So we've got a parking lot here. Why don't we go ahead and do, let's see. So based on how that goes, let's do some painting here. So we can do, this could be a single family. And here we can have row homes. There we go. Okay. Right. Let's keep putting some single family homes. All right. I think we should definitely have a parking lot here. It fits. Okay. All right, let's see. Back here, let's go with single family. Now here the topography starts getting a little wonky, so let's switch to this here. We'll do this. All right, we'll not do those there. Or here. Switch back over here, do these. Our pool. Right, let's do some parking across the street from the pool. We'll do medium. Maybe a lot of people want to come to the pool. And then here we'll do row houses here. Maybe an apartment complex there. I don't think we would have any commercial on a dead-end street like this. I don't think we would. Maybe in the beginning part, but not at the tail end, because that would cause a lot of people trying to do U-turns when they come visit. Right, I accidentally zoomed higher than I wanted to there.
For our feature story this hour, we're going live to Kim, who is downtown investigating.
Alright, so back to single family.
Defining commercial zones. So, what exactly is driving this sudden downswing in business, Kim?
Right.
Good question, Glenda. I'm standing outside what used to be one of the busiest stores in the city. Not long ago, it would open its doors to lines of customers 7 days a week. Now the place is shuttered, like most of the commercial buildings on this once thriving city block. And the question on everybody's minds, how could it have come to this?
Thanks, Kim. We'll have more with Kim after the break.
We're live, and we're getting reports about a traffic accident somewhere.
Right. I'll go ahead and throw another commercial building here. Let me do
and traffic flow should return to normal. But if
parking lot here,
out, you might want to wait a little while until everything clears up.
If you're in it, you,
and then we'll do, it's weird they didn't want one. And here we'll do
expect delays and drive safe.
Right. Maybe I'll do a walkway from the parking lot. Over that way, maybe to there. We do one that comes out like this. Maybe do some trees here. All Okay. Alright, let's keep zoning. Oh no, okay. That's already zoned. People just haven't decided to move in yet. So let's just keep going here. Yeah, look at that. We're finally making a bit of a dent there. All right, and then back here, I'm gonna kind of make this like a little walking park, I think. Kind of like come out from, oops, let me get closer. Go from here like this, back behind these guys. And then let's turn this about that. All right, let's see what we can do. The curve here, maybe go, let's see, go curve. Nope. That's not quite what I was looking for, but you know what? I'm gonna go with it. Another path out to the beach. Here. All right, and then this will just all be with filled in with trees. Oh, you know what? Before I do that, let's see. Let's go bush. Go flower bush. All right, let's see here. And I'll put trees in afterwards with the big brush. Let me see something. There you go. All right, cool. I don't know why, but I just wanted something kind of like that. Not that chaotic, perhaps, but something kind of like that. Like City Planner Plays always says, these wildlife assets always take a long time to grow, so you want to plant them early. It takes like a year or something for them to reach full size. A year in-game, that is. Alright, and then let's go to, do I want pines, spruce? I don't think I want spruce. Can I fit one in there? I can't. Alright, so let's go multiple. I think I'm going to have to place them individually. Let's see. Ah, there. Too close. Okay. And Let's go here. It's one of those, like, since it snows here, this is one of those northern latitudes where it, there's, like, pine trees and stuff at the beach. Not like Florida where there's palm trees. Maybe that'll come with the beach DLC that is delayed right now while they work on the bugs, fixing the bugs. Alright. I'll add more bushes later. Right now I just want to do the trees. And while I have this brush on, I'm just going to go through the whole neighborhood, just add trees wherever they will pop in. Forest over here. Increase the size here. Let there be trees. I already have some homes emerging here. Population is increasing. Lots of people moving in. Alright, I think we need a new district here. These guys. Coleridge Bluff. Sure, why not? Let's see what Coleridge Bluff looks like. Oh, look at all the people moving in, presumably. So, let's go here. Alright. Take a photo. And let's... Yes, we'll follow this. Oh, we have to go into the. Let's see. Gotcha. So he takes a drive through the new neighborhood we've built here. Presumably moving into one of the new units. This guy doesn't have any license tags. We've got like this kind of big mountain bluff area. Then we've got the trees over here. Looking really nice. There's our radio mast providing internet. And there's an apartment building over there. Maybe that's where he's headed to. We're looking good, looking good. That house there. Very cool. I thought I had put down grass and trees. For some reason there's trees here without grass. We've got this thing here to keep the dirt from coming in. Got all these... What in the heck just happened here? He just drove through a mountain or something. It was weird. Alright, there's a parking spot here. Including place to charge your EVs. Oh, there's the diving board from the swimming pool. Community pool. Alright, this is looking good. Whoa. Alright, that was some weird parallel parking. But okay. I guess this person lives in this row house or something. What is he doing? For a second, I thought he was like taking a selfie or something. Maybe he is. I think he's supposed to be. Kind of a chubby dude. Alright, someone just came out over here. Going over to that apartment complex over there. Alright, I like this neighborhood. It's very cool. Look at all these window AC units. Yeah, not bad. Very nice assets. Alright, well, this has been Eric playing City Skylines 2. I'll see you next time. Goodbye.